The next thing I'm going to talk about is helium dilution and nitrogen washout. So these, once again, are two other terms. These are, once again, important as if you remember the spirometry video, or if you've watched it, or if you haven't, I don't care. But these, once again, are only ventilation gas. So if you have air trap gas, it doesn't really work. So just keep that in mind. So helium dilution. So some fun facts about helium. Helium does not dissolve. So it won't. So any helium that you have here at the concentration will be here at the very end of the experiment. And that's important because what we're trying to do is we're trying to figure out the total lung volume that we have. So this is a TLC. And well, this is like TLC from like a from a ventilation standpoint, right? So everything has to be ventilated. So what's going to happen is you're going to be breathing normally, and they're going to have a certain amount of air in here. Like, it'll be oxygen with like some concentration of helium that's already determined. And what they're going to do is they're going to have you breathe in and out so that all the helium will acclimate or disperse equally within the whole system. Of course, this is only ventilated part, right? So you're going to be breathing in and out for a bunch of times. And what's going to happen is all the helium is going to be equilibrated out. They're going to calculate the volume of this tube that went to your mouth, and they know the volume that was in here. So what they're going to do is, after they've acclimated the helium, then they're going to close it off, and then they're going to measure the helium concentration in here, and based off those facts, then they're able to determine the volume in here based off of how much the concentration decreased of helium within this box. And once again, helium does not get absorbed or does not like diffuse, and that's then the good thing is because you will have like a constant pressure of helium in here, and it won't be like being getting rid of. That's helium dilution. Nitrogen washout. So currently, like, or the way we breathe right now is we're like 79% N2, 21% O2, and like 0% CO2, 0.003, I think. But we have a lot of nitrogen, so we round up to 80%, right? So we're saying 80% nitrogen is in our system right now, we're breathing it in. But we have 20% O2, and what we're trying to figure out is how well you're ventilating, and is the ventilation equal? And I'm gonna be getting more into that right now. And like most graphs, I probably should label this. This will be N2 concentration, or This will be time. And this will be like N2 concentration or percentage of N2. And so we assume that we have 80% nitrogen in our system right now. And what they do is they let you breathe normally at room air, which this is room air, and then they switch you on to 100% O2, which means that if you're in real resp, the FiO2 is going to be 1.0. That's what they're putting you on right now. And what they do is, so you breathe in one, like, and it could be tidal, one, whatever, it doesn't really matter how you're breathing it in, but you're breathing in one, like, breath of air, and then it goes in one tube. And then through a different tube, well, I think it's the tube that, there's a tube in the middle of it, but it doesn't really matter. There's another tube that goes out, and this tube goes out into a box. And it measures the percentages of oxygen and nitrogen in the box. So the first breath you breathe out will be like a certain percentage of nitrogen. And so it adds up. Then, from what I've been reading, this volume disappears. But you still remember the percentage of nitrogen that you found in here. Then the next breath of pure oxygen comes in, and the next one comes out. And then you're gonna measure the amount of nitrogen in that as well. And you're gonna add it to the previous breath's nitrogen. So you're summating your nitrogen as you go through. So the nitrogen really isn't actually increasing. The percentage isn't increasing, but the summation of it increases. So with each breath, you're supposed to get more and more nitrogen until you reach 80%. Or yeah, so 80%, or 100% of nitrogen, which would be 80%. But you should not get more than that because room air is 80% nitrogen. This is the graph that I appreciate the most because it's very simple. This, I don't really like, but that was like one of the ways it was presented to us in class. But, blue. So, just erase this junk. So it's another way of just looking at this graph pretty much, but it's saying that you're starting off at 80% nitrogen right here, and then it looks at your first breath, and then it just works backwards. So it assumes you already have 80, and it just starts subtracting breath one, then breath two, and then breath three, and then it keeps on going forward, and it goes down, down, down. And it should be uniform, and if it's uniform, that means that you have equal ventilation. The way the air is going into your lungs is dispersing throughout all 20 terminal bronchi or tertiary bronchi. That's the way it works. If you have an obstructive disease, which means increased resistance, it does not look like this. Say, and this is like a classic picture, and you have like one alveoli that looks like this, and you have one alveoli that's, sorry, like this, like some weird looking one. And so ventilation here happens really nice here, but not really that much here. And you'll be able to detect this because you're going to see a drop off in your amount of nitrogen that you're going to be getting in that next breath. So the line will actually look like this. It'll still look similar like this, and then I'll just like teeter off like this. And this is representing that so you're still adding your breaths right here, but the reason why this is not going down is because, and this is why it's like kind of sketchy and it's better to use this. This one, it would be percent nitrogen would be like this. And it would just be staying normal because you're not, the readout on that breath when you're expiring is not picking up any nitrogen. So you're not adding anything to the next breath. Even though you know that there should be 80% nitrogen. So if the line will go like this and just like tail off. And then this right here would be some portion of your lungs that's not being ventilated. So once again, these are both ventilations or ventilation required. Two other ways of looking at just how your body works. Hope that helped. Sorry, I didn't go on a tangent.